Starting Football with Ronnie Huckeba.
Hi, and welcome to this week's edition of Harding Football with Ronnie Huckeba. The Bisons saw the nation's fifth-ranked Henderson State Reddies on Saturday afternoon. And, Coach, we knew going in what a challenge that would be for your football team, but a great atmosphere at First Security Stadium on Saturday. And I thought it was a game in which two teams really gave each other its best shot right off the bat. What a great first half.
Well, it was the kind of game that you want to be playing in this time of the year, Billy. And the homecoming crowd just made it that much more special. Two very quality teams. You know, as you said, Henderson, the number five ranked team in the country. We knew it was going to be a great challenge, but, you know, our guys prepared wonderfully during the week. Coaches had a great game plan. And it turned out to be just what we expected. You know, there are a few plays we'd like to have back, but very proud of the way that our guys competed. We competed at a very high level in that football game. Then we also know that there were a few mistakes in that game that really cost us a chance to win. And as we move forward, we gotta correct those things, you know, so we can compete at the highest level. That's what this group wants to do. That's what our program wants to do. And but there, you know, when we talked about this game last week, preparing for it, one of our themes was make a memory. And I think we made some really good memories in this football game. There's some things that happened in the course of the game that I don't think I'll ever forget.
Yeah, and you talk about a game like that, and to have a game like that on campus in which it's just a great crowd and the number five team on campus and folks getting to see a game like that happen right here at First Security Stadium. What did that type of atmosphere mean for the program?
Well, I hope that's just a preview of things to come. Yeah, we want our football program to be at a point where we're playing those meaningful games every year. And that's the direction that we're headed. We're very proud of our players and the work that they're putting in and the coaches and the work that they're putting in. And we feel like we are very, very close to being an elite program in Division II. And we just got to keep rolling up our sleeves and going to work. That's how you get there.
All right, so we have a lot of highlights to get to. And we'll start with the start of the game right after this. Welcome back to Harding Football with Ronnie Huckeba, and we knew it was a high-powered offense the Bisons were going to see on Saturday afternoon. They score on the first play offensively from scrimmage to go up 7-0 on your football team, but I thought your team's response to come back and put a solid drive together right here with Ahmad Scott getting things started in a positive way for the Bisons was very crucial.
Without a doubt, Billy, and that was a great way to get started. You know, we got the toss going early, and we got Romo going early. That was huge. Did a few different things against these guys because of the way that they schemed us the last couple of years defensively. And we were pleased with the way that worked out. You know, this is Donatello making something out of nothing. There was not really anything there. And the way he finished off that run, I think, also sent a message to Henderson that, you know, we were there to play. We come back with the draw play on third down, which we have not run much lately, and it was real effective for us in this ball game. And there's the quick screen, actually just the fast screen to Donatello with no blocking. They're playing off of him. We feel real good about him with the ball in space. He made a great play, and we ended up getting a field goal. John Gay getting a field goal and getting him going again was really good for us.
That finished a 71-yard drive for your football team.
We come back, and on defense, we get some critical stops. you know, these guys are so dynamic offensively with their possessions that, you know, you gotta get some stops if you're gonna hang with them. And we did a real good job of this. This is great pressure by Matt Cain and Daniel Riley. We thought we might have had a chance for a safety, but still a great job. And then we come back and finish this drive off with the quarterback follow with Keenan Kellett. And this is the next drive, I believe. We get the option going, get it kicked to Jason Oller. Great blocking out in front of him by Denico Jackson-Best and others. And that was a very, very big play for us. We come back with a power play to Romo. And, you know, this guy has had a great year, and I think he'd be the first one to tell you one of the reasons he has is because of the blocking that he gets up in front of him. We come back and finish this drive off with a trap play, and Romo gets into the end zone. Good blocking up front. And, you know, it's back and forth.
Yeah, great first half. And teams know that Romo's coming at them, but Coach still having a hard time stopping him. And you talked about the big guys up front. Four straight games for Romo for over 100 yards. A big fake punt here for B.J. Jones.
Yeah, this was. And, you know, Coach Clay Beeson does a great job with this punt team. And we've worked this fake all year long. And it was the right time to make the call. And it worked out really good for us.
And when B.J., to go back to that, you know, he's used to running the football, a former fullback.
Yeah, you know, he was a real good running back in high school.
Big play to end the first half offensively right here for your team, and then they missed the field goal.
Right. So we go into halftime, I think 28-24 is a score. And as we said, it's been a barn burner. Now, we, you know, two of those plays that they got in there were two long plays that, you know, the kickoff return in the first play of the game that we wish we could have limited.
This is after Robert Jordan's catch for the touchdown, and then he suffered the injury, and the two teams come together here, and obviously it's a somber moment, but great to see the two teams come together and have thoughts and prayers together.
Well, football's important, but this is more important. You know, this is what Division II athletics and all athletics should be about, supporting each other in a crisis situation right there. Robert's a great player. We really hurt for him with that injury. And, you know, we were blessed to be able to come together out there and pray for him. Denico on the power play, and we come back with a toss to Ahmad. We get a little bit going out there. We've got a short yardage situation. We feel like we're going to convert that. We miss the middle linebacker, and that's not a guy that you want to miss. That's Keaton Stigger, one of the best football players in our conference. And he made us pay right there. We get the option going again back into the boundary, get it kicked to Jason. And we come back with a bootleg to Donatello. He's wide open. Keenan does a good job of getting the ball to him, and they shake the ball loose. That was a big play in the ball game. You know, we felt like we really had something going there. We come back with the ball, the hitch to Donatello again. I think Donatello had 8 catches in this ball game, and that's the largest number that we've had this year for one receiver. The option again with Keenan. He keeps it, does a good job with his hand fakes, and we're moving, and we end up with the field goal attempt again with John, and he knocks it down.
And the field goal would make it 38-27, still very much a part of this football game at this point.
Right. You know, we felt like we were in the ball game, mm-hmm. You know, pretty much the entire game, and this is a fantastic play by Ashton Williams to chase this guy down, knock the ball out. Corey Bassett picks it up. You know, Corey's one of the fastest players on our team and one of the fastest players in our conference. And you know, he brings the ball out almost to the 30. So we got another shot again. Come back with the reverse to Donatella. This time he's got a little bit more room, gets the perimeter on him, and converts the first down. That was a big conversion.
Yeah, this is a big drive to try to get it back to a one-score game right now.
Right. Yeah, you have to give their defense credit. You know, they held us to field goals in situations where we really needed to score touchdowns in the second half. And we were glad for, you know, as I said earlier, we were really glad to get John going, but, man, we needed to put 7 points on the board in both of those situations.
That got it back to an 8-point game, 38-30. Emily Owens being crowned there as the homecoming queen this year for the Bisons, and the Bisons would eventually fall 45-30. A late touchdown for Henderson State was the final numbers in the football game. But I want to go back to Romo Westbrook, 161 yards rushing. That's only the third Bison that's gone for 100 yards or more four straight games. We talked about Chris Pearson a week ago. He did it four times in 97.
Right.
And then you have to go back to Alan Dixon did it twice. So he, in talking about Romo, is in very good company there. And again, the offensive line, big part of that.
Right. Well, those two guys you just mentioned, Chris Pearson, Alan Snake Dixon is what we call
it. That's what Coach Mode always calls him.
Those are two of the best running backs that have ever been at Harding. And, you know, dynamic football players that racked up big-time numbers. And for Romo to be mentioned in that category, I think, is a tribute to him. It's a tribute to our offensive line, but it's also a tribute to our quarterback because, you know, in order for Romo to get those creases that he gets, we have to have great blocking up front, but we also have to have a quarterback that's reading the, you know, the triple option correctly. The first phase is the give to the fullback, and, you know, when they don't close down and take him, we got to get him the ball, and we've done a good job of that through the course of the season. So, a lot of things go into that, but also Romo is great with the ball in his hands. He's got fantastic balance, good vision, and he's really good after contact. And I think all those things go together to allow him to accomplish what he's accomplished up to this point.
And in a football game like we saw on Saturday, when a nationally ranked opponent comes to town and a team like yours that is so well thought of, and really two of the top teams regionally in this part of the region and obviously in the conference, when you come together, big plays are a big part of it. And I thought the big plays on Saturday, the 100-yard touchdown, the kickoff from Henderson State was a big point in the game. And also we saw the fake punt in which B.J. Jones was able to get the first down, but Henderson State ultimately keeps the Bisons out of the end zone on that drive, and that was a big series also. The two big scenarios to me.
I think you're right. The kickoff return, you know, that one reason that was disappointing is we kicked from the 50 on that. And you would think, you know, we'd get that ball out of the end zone. We didn't. And I think sometimes what happens in a situation like that is your kickoff team assumes, you know, with a short kick, that you're going to knock it out of the end zone. And so maybe they relax just a little bit, and that's what happened. You can't relax. You know, you got to cover. And so that was a really tough point in the game for that to happen. And then after we converted the fake punch, you know, boy, you need to take that in and score. You need to get points off of that. The fourth down, you know, where they stopped us, you know, we believe we can make any fourth down and convert it. And, you know, but in order to do that, you've got to execute. And we, you know, there were times on Saturday where we didn't. There are times on Saturday when they didn't either. You know, it was a situation where you had two really good football teams. And when you get right down to it, as we said earlier, it's probably going to come down to big plays and opportunities. And in a lot of our red zone opportunities, we ended up with field goals instead of touchdowns. And you know, it's hard to do. It's hard to match those guys because they're so dynamic.
A lot of scoring in that first half, not so much in the third quarter. And I thought the injury was a big part of the third quarter, obviously, when Robert Jordan went down. And I'd be remiss if I didn't mention what a great bunch of kids that you have on your program. I know they really followed up with Robert Jordan after the injury.
They did, and I think that's just an indication of the kind of hearts that those guys have. You got to hurt for somebody in his situation. He's one of the best players in Division II. And, even though, because he went out, it limited what they did offensively. Nobody on our football team felt good about that. You know, you want to play somebody when they're at their best, when they're full strength. And, when you got a guy that has accomplished as much as he has, you want to see him get to finish his year out. And now that he has been injured, and it was a devastating injury, you know, it's just the right thing to do to try to support him. You know, he had his surgery here in Searcy at White County Hospital, and so he's up in the hospital by himself. So it's a great thing that several of our players and coaches went to visit him in the hospital. And I think that bonds you. You know, that makes you realize that football is just a game, and you know, life is about taking care of people.
Right, absolutely. Stay with us. We will come back and look ahead to this week when the Bisons hit the road to southeastern Oklahoma on Saturday. We'll come back and talk with Coach about that right after this.
I'm lucky. Let me help you with that. I get to do something I love. It has nothing to do with touchdowns or titles.
Everybody bring it in.
I get to play a part in the life of someone just starting out.
How many of you think homework is just as important as teamwork?
I help keep kids in school.
Good.
And that's the name of the game.
My name is LaDainian Thomason. I don't just wear the shirt, I live it.
Give, advocate, volunteer. Live United.
We were drawn here from all 50 states and more than 50 different nations. We are 7,000 students of languages, arts, sciences, and life. As diverse as our origins and as different as our backgrounds are, it's remarkable how much we have in common here in this place of faith, learning, and living. Harding University.
Welcome back to Harding Football with Ronnie Huckeba as the Bisons getting ready now to hit the road next week as we hit the road to Oklahoma once again, southeastern Oklahoma. And we went to southeastern Oklahoma a year ago, Coach, and they gave the Bisons all that we wanted last year.
You know, Billy, one thing about this staff, the head coach, Ray Richards, is an old defensive coach, and he's been around a while. They had a real good understanding of how to defend our offense and did a really good job with it last year. This football team has played really well at home. And, you know, they beat SAU in the opening game of the season, 56-50, ran 100-plus plays. They played with Henderson really until late in the ball game. And they've had some really tough games. In addition to that, they had a barn burner at homecoming with Texas A&M Commerce. It ended up being like 31-29, so they can score points. They play hard on defense, and they've got an understanding of how to defend our offense, so we got our work cut out for us.
And homecoming this past week, even though a loss for your football team, it was a great weekend, I think, to be a Bison and to see the sights and the sounds all around campus. Talk about your favorite. Is there one favorite homecoming moment? I know you have so many because you were very successful as a player.
Well, you know, when I think back to recent years, probably 2006, we had another football game with Henderson State. They had a really good football team that year, and we were, I think we were 5-2 going into that game. We went into overtime with them. They had a really strong defense, and we managed to scrape together, two or three touchdowns, went into overtime, stopped them with their possession. Then on the first play of overtime, as far as our offensive possession was concerned, we threw a little quick screen out in the flat to a receiver named Devin Link. We had a bunch of offensive linemen out in front of him getting knocked down blocks, and he went into the end zone untouched, and that ended the football game. That was a great memory for me. I guess the other memories for me regarding homecoming would revolve around my family being here. I've got six grandkids, and I had two little girls that were here this past Saturday with Hope and her husband John, my daughter, and that's always special. You know, no matter what happens in a football game, when you got two little girls want to hug your neck after the game's over, it makes you feel better.
Yeah. All right, Coach. Great to be with you as always. We'll hit the road and talk to you about the Southeastern game next week.
All right, Billy. Thank you.
That's all for this week's edition of Harding Football with Ronnie Huckeba. We'll close this week's show as we will look back at the sights and sounds of homecoming at Harding University, put together by Kyle Reeves.
I'm coming home to you. Every night. I'm the colorless sunrise. It's never good enough. I'm the wind that's in your hair that ruffles you up. If you could find a reason, you could let me know. Just turn and go. I'm coming.
chasing, it don't matter, it don't matter. Cause the reason that I'm here is the same through all these years. I'm not changing, not changing anything at all.